blind cast at best. That is known by those who want to be long loved. Sour apples are there, no doubt.
Thank you. Thank you.
giver. Thus passed with the lonesome 1 month and years. His wisdom meanwhile increased, and caused him pain by its abundance. One morning, however, he awoke ere the rosy dawn, and having meditated long on his couch, at last spake thus to him. And quoth, O Zarathustra and quoth, why did I startle in my dream, so that I awoke? Did not a child come to me, carrying a mirror? Said the child unto me and quoth, thank you. with media slowly laughing and thrilling. At me virtuous ones, lacked my beauty today. And thus came its voice unto me, and quoth, they want to be paid besides. And quoth, ye want to be paid besides, me virtuous ones. Me want green. Lord for virtue, and heaven for earth, and eternity for your today. And might upbraid me for teaching that there is no reward giver, nor paymaster. And verily, I do not even teach that virtue is its own reward. Ah! This is my sorrow. Into the basis of things have reward and punishment been insinuated, and now even into the basis of your souls, ye virtuous ones. But like the snout of the boar shall my word rub up the basis of your souls, a plowshare will I be called by you. All the secrets of your heart shall be brought to light, and when ye lie in the sun, rubbed up and broken, then will also your falsehood be separated from your truth. For this is your truth. Ye are too pure for the filth of the words, vengeance, punishment, recompense, retribution. You love your virtue as a mother loveth her child, but when did one hear of a mother wanting to be paid for her love? It is your dearest self, your virtue. The ring as thirst is in you, to reach itself again struggle every ring, and turn it itself. And like the star that blew about, so is every work of your virtue. Ever is its light on its way and traveling, and when will it cease to be on its way? Thus is the light of your virtue still on its way, even when its work is done. Be it forgotten and dead, still its ray of light liveth and travel left. That your virtue is yourself, and not an outward thing, eh? The virtuous, I.O.I. skin, or a cloak, that is the truth from the basis of your souls, ye virtuous ones. But sure enough there are those to whom virtue meaneth writhing under the lash, indeed a mark and too much unto. They're crying, and others are there who call virtue the slothfulness of their vices, and when once their hatred and jealousy relax the limbs, their enquoth, justice enquoth, becometh lively and rubbeth its sleepy eyes. And others are there who are drawn downwards, there, devils draw them, but the more they sink, the more ardently loweth their eye, and the longing for their God. Ah! Their crying also hath reached your ears, ye virtuous ones, and quoth, what I am not, that is God to me, and virtue, and quoth. And others are there who go along heavily and creakingly, like carts taking stones downhill. They talk much of dignity and virtue, their drag they call virtue. And others are there who are like 8-day clocks when wound up. They tick, and want people to call ticking virtue. Verily, in those have I mine amusement, their and in quad, eagle, and quad. But Zarathustra came not to say unto all those liars and fools, and quad, what do ye know of virtue? What could ye know of virtue, and quad? But that ye, my friends, might become weary of the old words which ye have learned from the fools and liars, that ye might become weary of the words and quod, the Lord, and quod, brethren. Ocean, and quod,